subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. The tourism sector is emerging as one of the most booming sectors in the world. With time, the sector has undergone great diversification and development and has now become a symbol of growth for many countries. Recognizing the importance of universal growth, with the strengthening of tourism and travel, every year on 27th September, World Tourism Day is celebrated across the globe. So today, let's see how this day was celebrated across various parts in India.
Owing to its distinct geographical existence and wide variety of options that it offers in terms of cuisines, art, music forms, language, adventures and places, India has become the most sought-after tourist destination. Recently, as the World Tourism Day was observed across the globe, a number of events were also conducted in various parts of India to give boost to its tourism sector. In Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, a number of water sport activities like shikara racing, canoeing and kayaking were organized at the Dal Lake that saw participation of a number of enthusiasts. The water body is known as a popular tourist spot across the world for its unique shikara boats and houseboat stays.
यही एक्चुअली हमारा जो मकसद है ये करने का कि हम लोगों को मैसेज देना चाहते हैं बाहर के लोगों को कि आप लोग आइए यहाँ पे कश्मीर जम्मू कश्मीर आइए हम वेलकम कर रहे हैं कोई परेशानी नहीं है यहाँ पे हाँ कोविड की वजह से जो थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हो गई थी जो टूरिस्ट घूमना चाहते हैं वो नहीं घूम सकते हैं लेकिन अब कोई परेशानी नहीं है
बहुत बूस्ट मिलेगा कि क्योंकि आज बहुत एक्टिविटीज़ हो रही है कायाकिंग हो रहा है कैनान हो रही है साइकिलिंग हो रही है और रनिंग हो रही है तो मैंने भी आज 15 किलोमीटर रन की अराउंड द डाल तो इससे बहुत बूस्ट मिलेगा Tourism department.
In Mashobra Valley of Himachal Pradesh, one-day cycling race was organized by Himalayan Adventure Sports and Tourism Promotion Association or HASTPA to celebrate the day. Around 50 local cyclists participated in the competition that started from Dug Bungalow near Kufri and covered a total distance of 50 kilometers. The terrain was challenging and comprised of single tracks, jeep tracks, forest trails and loose gravel tracks among the pristine deodar forest of Shimla, Kufri and Mashobra.
मुझे लगता है कि younger generations के लिए fitness के लिए और motivation के लिए एक outdoor sport है इससे हर तरह की इंसान की development हो सकती है mentally, physically, emotionally तो आउटडोर स्पोर्ट्स का मैं बहुत बड़ा फॉलोअर हूं और मुझे लगता है कि ऐसे इवेंट्स ज़्यादा होने चाहिए और ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोगों को ऐसे इवेंट्स में पार्टिसिपेट करना चाहिए।
Meanwhile, in Varanasi city of Uttar Pradesh, Alaknanda cruise service that gives people tours of river Ganga, with a world-class facility resumed its operations on the World Tourism Day. This year, the day was observed with the theme Tourism and Rural Development to celebrate the unique role that tourism plays in providing opportunities outside of big cities and preserving cultural and natural heritage all over the world.
Sufism has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. The northern state of Uttar Pradesh serves as a rich reservoir of this tradition because of its association with the Ganga Jamuni Tehzeeb, which binds two of India's major religious groups, Hindus and Muslims, in a common knot of harmony. So, giving a glimpse of this unique devotional culture, today we take you to the Dargah of Latif Shah Baba in Kanpur district of the state to get a glimpse of this amiable bond which is shared by the citizens.
For the last many years, the shrine of Latif Shah Baba in Kanpur district of Uttar Pradesh is serving as a cynosure of unification between myriad faiths practiced in India. Devotees, irrespective of caste or community, bow their head before the shrine and offer respect to the revered Sufi saint who throughout his life spread the message of peace and brotherhood. They believe that this dargah is the last resort where all the problems would end.
Sarkar ki chaukat pe sab mari jaate hain. Kisi ko kuch karaya ho ya kisi ko koi ausheb ho या कोई ऐसी परेशानी शैतानी मामलात हैं या अस्पताल से मरीज उठ के आता है उन सब का इलाज होता है हर धर्म के लोग आते हैं हाँ हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख भी आते हैं
Situated in the Bakarmandi area of Kanpur district, the holy site is thronged by a number of devotees every year. People take part in salutations, supplications, sermons and night-long prayers where Sufi scholars and imams throw light on the life, religious service, teachings and spiritual strength of the saint who devoted his entire life to serve humanity. Devotees believe that whosoever offers his prayers with complete devotion to the saint, all his sufferings and troubles come to an end as the saint showers his blessing on them.
Sarkar Latif Shah Baba ki dargah bahut hi purani hai. Yahan hum log ka ye manna hai ki har musibat ka hal nikal aata hai bina lagaye. Aur yahan kisi ko kuch dena lena nahi padta. Bas aate hain sir baba se baat karte hain mani man aur apne ghar ko chale jate hain. Usse baba apne फैज़ो करम से नवाजते हैं कोई सभी धर्म के लोग आते हैं कोई किसी बीमारी में मुब्तला है कोई अवसेब में मुब्तला है कोई इलाज में मुब्तला है कोई किसी की तकलीफ है कोई किसी की तकलीफ हर प्रकार की तकलीफ रूहानी फैज मिलता है
सिंस एजेस द सूफी सेंट लाइक लतीफ शाह बाबा हैव प्रोपगेटेड द मैसेज ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिज्म एंड हार्मनी इन आवर कंट्री And their teachings are still playing a significant role in binding different faiths together.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A youngster from Jammu and Kashmir is making lives easier of his fellow citizens by delivering the taste of home-cooked meal at their doorsteps. Called as a tiffin aw or tiffin come home service, Rais Ahmed is serving the forgotten home cooked delicacies of the Kashmir Valley in nicely packed lunch boxes, which is winning hearts. The motive behind Rais' tiffin service is to inculcate healthy eating habits in individuals and spread the message of avoiding consumption of junk. And unhealthy food items, especially in times of the pandemic.
हमारा ये जो टिफिन आव है, ये एक ऐसी सर्विस है हम लोगों तक खाना पहुंचाते हैं वो भी हाइजीनिक और हेल्दी और फ्रेश जो लोग फील्ड में काम करते रहते हैं चाहे वो एम्प्लॉयज हो शॉपकीपर्स हो स्टूडेंट्स हो कोई भी हो और वो खाने की तलाश में रहता है और फिर उसको जाना पड़ता है कई जगहों पर खाना खाने के लिए हमारा बेसिकली मकसद यह है लोगों को फास्ट फूड से दूर रखने का क्योंकि आप देखिए कश्मीर में बहुत सारी बीमारियां अरूज पे है, लाइक कैंसर, स्टोमक कैंसर, उसमें उसका रीज़न ये है कि फास्ट फूड में मतलब बहुत सारे ऐसे टेस्टिंग पाउडर्स यूज़ किए जाते हैं जो कि इलीगल है और जिसको खाने से इंसान का सेहत बहुत ही ख़राब होता है। तो हमारी ये कोशिश है लोगों तक साफ़ सुथरा खाना पहुँचाना और हेल्दी खाना पहुँचाना, और हमारे खानों में ज़्यादा मसाले वगैरह भी यूज़ नहीं होते हैं, जितना लिमिटेड होना चाहिए उतना ही हम होममेड फूड लोगों तक पहुंचाते हैं।
Rais Ahmed started his tiffin service on February 3rd last year. However, after a halt, he decided to resume his services on popular demand amid the COVID-19 crisis with a motive to help his fellow citizens. Indian and Japanese navies recently concluded the 3-day maritime bilateral joint exercise in the northern part of the Arabian Sea. The exercise, dubbed as JIMX 20, began on September 26, where the two navies carried out extensive maritime ops for 3 days. Indian Embassy in Japan tweeted, JIMX 2020 will further enhance cooperation and mutual confidence between Indian Navy and Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force and fortify long-standing bond of friendship between India and Japan. Last week, India conducted a joint military exercise with the Royal Australian Navy as well in Indian Ocean region. It has also conducted a couple of military exercises with the members of informal Quad grouping that also include USA. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently held a bilateral summit with his Danish counterpart Mette Frederiksen via video conferencing. The two countries held talks on a wide range of topics, including climate change. Modi highlighted the importance of working together with like-minded countries like Denmark, which shares a rules-based, transparent, humanitarian, and democratic value system. Denmark is one of India's biggest foreign direct investors, and the bilateral trade between the two countries reached $3.68 billion in 2019, an increase over 30% from 2016 as per government figures. Cinema theatres in India are gearing up to open after government issued new unlock guidelines, even as coronavirus cases in the country continue to rise rapidly. India's federal government has allowed states to reopen theatres from October 15 with 50% capacity. Workers were seen cleaning and sanitising cinema halls as theatre owners took precautions to ensure safety of the moviegoers and prevent the spread of the virus. 7 months after
the government guidelines were given, after that the state government will give. स्टेट गवर्नमेंट क्या गाइडलाइन देती है उस हिसाब से हम खोलने के लिए तैयार हैं, और 7 महीने से कर्मचारियों को सैलरी दे रहे हैं। काफ़ी हालत ख़राब है कर्मचारियों की, लेकिन हम एडजस्ट करके चल रहे हैं।
इंडस्ट्री फिगर्स शो इंडिया मेक्स 1200 फिल्म्स इन अ टिपिकल ईयर, while there are 9500 theaters that have been shut down completely in the last 6 months. India imposed a strict nationwide lockdown in March, but in recent months slowly lifted restrictions amid rising concerns of a sharp slowdown in economic growth.
It is said happiness doesn't result from what we get, but from what we give. This quote perfectly encapsulates the motive with which few youngsters in Chandigarh are working. In their recent endeavor, they distributed food packets among underprivileged children to bring smiles on their faces, along with serving a greater cause amid the pandemic. Have a look.
In these times of pandemic, when there is an atmosphere of sorrow and suffering all around, these two groups of youngsters in Chandigarh are bringing smiles to hundreds of faces. Popularly known as Team Prerna and Robin Hood Army, they recently distributed 700 food packets among the underprivileged children, no matter which caste or community they belong to. They named these packets containing buttermilk, cake, biscuit and a mask as Kiddo Delight or Happiness Kit.
हमारा जो कॉन्सेप्ट आया था हमें लगा कि सपोज ऐसे निक्स खुला और काफ़ी सारे रेस्टोरेंट्स खुले थे तो हम सब लोग तो जा पा रहे थे बट इन बच्चों का क्या, उनको तो ऐसी कोई सुविधा नहीं मिल रही थी तो हमने सोचा कि हमें अपने लेवल पे कुछ करना चाहिए तो हमने सोचा कि हम बस एक छोटी सी रकम पे कुछ आइटम्स इकट्ठे करेंगे और उन बच्चों को हम उन बच्चों को देंगे ताकि जो खुशी हमें मिलती है हम खुशी इनके साथ भी बांट सकें बिकॉज जितना हम बांटते हैं उतना ही हमारे को और खुशी मिलती है, दुगनी खुशी मिलती है। तो इसी छोटी सी सोच को लेकर हमने ड्राइव का प्लान किया और हमने 10 रुपये के आइटम्स इकट्ठे करे, जैसे लस्सी, केक्स, बिस्किट्स, और हम इन लोगों के बीच में बांटने आए हैं।
अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मोटिव इज़ टू ऑल्सो गिव अ मास्क, सो वी आर ऑल्सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग अ मास्क। इट्स रियली इंपॉर्टेंट टू वेयर अ मास्क ड्यूरिंग दिस पेंडेमिक, इट हेल्प्स, इट प्रोवाइड सेफ्टी, इट्स रियली इंपॉर्टेंट, सो दैट्स अनदर मोटिव। वन इज हैप्पीनेस, द सेकेंड इज टू गिव हैंड ओवर अ मास्क।
Both the groups first assembled the children and then made them stand in a proper line. Children patiently waited for their turn as the youngsters started distributing the happiness kits among them. During the drive, volunteers took care of all the precautionary measures and followed the social distancing norms to avoid the spread of virus. They also urged people to contribute their bit to the society, either by associating themselves with an NGO or at an individual level.
जरूरी नहीं आप रॉबिन हुड के साथ या किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ जुड़ के ही आप सोशल वर्क कर सकते हो। आपके आसपास में भी, पड़ोस में भी कोई अगर बच्चा आपको मिलता है और जो लगता है कि आपको मतलब जेन्युइन है, उसको कुछ नीड्स है, राशन का, शूज का, कुछ भी, तो आप वो भी दे सकते हो। जरूरी नहीं रॉबिन हुड के साथ या किसी भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ जुड़ के करो। आसपास भी कोई दिखता है तो आप उसको मदद करो डायरेक्टली। ऐसा नहीं कि आप रॉबिन हुड के साथ या किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ जुड़ के करो, तो डायरेक्टली कर सकते हो हेल्प सर।
Such acts of generosity by a group of teenagers in Chandigarh are not just inspirational, but also motivate us to rise above all biases and think about those who are underprivileged.
Education is the movement from darkness to light. An educated mind helps individuals in making well-informed choices, which paves the way towards a secure future. While authorities keep on taking a number of steps for educating children and youngsters in the country, a number of scholars and commoners have also come to the forefront to educate the society in different possible ways. One such man is Nanda Prusthi from the eastern state of Odisha, who has spent his entire life in educating children of his village. A report.
A 104-year-old man is often seen sitting under a tree in the noon with a stick in hand reciting phonetics and numbers to children. This man is Nanda Prusthi, better known as Nanda Sir from Jajpur district of Odisha. He has dedicated his entire life to the cause of providing basic education to people.
ମୋତେ ହେଇଥିଲା 30 ବର୍ଷ ରାତିରେ ପଢ଼ା ଏ ବଡ଼ ବଡ଼ ମଣିଷ ରାତି ପଢ଼ା ସାରିକିରି ଏ ଛୁଆଙ୍କୁ ପଢ଼ାଏ ନେଇକିରି ସକାଳୁ ଚାଷ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ମୁଁ ଭାତ ଫାତ ନେଇକି ଯାଏ ଏ ବ୍ୟବସ୍ଥା କରୁ ଦେଖିଲି ଆମ ଗାଁରେ ବହୁତ ଥିଲେ ପଢ଼ିନଥିଲେ ନାଁ ଦସ୍ତଖତ କରିପାରିନଥିଲେ ତାପରେ ସିଏମାନେ ଟିପ ଚିହ୍ନ ଦେଉଥିଲେ ତାଙ୍କୁ କାହାକୁ ଦସ୍ତଖତ କରେଇ ଶିଖେଇଲି କିଏ ଗୀତ ଭାଗବତ ବୋଲିଲା କିଏ କ'ଣ କରିଗଲା ତା ସାରା ଯେଉଁମାନେ ପାଠ ପଢ଼ିଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କ ପୁଅଙ୍କୁ ପଢ଼େଇ ତାଙ୍କ ପୁଅକୁ ପଢ଼େଇ ତାଙ୍କ ପୁଅକୁ ଏଇନା ପଢ଼େଇ ତାଙ୍କ ପୁଅ ଏଇନା ପଢ଼ୁଛନ୍ତି ଖାଲି ବସନ୍ତ ହଇଜା ଆଉ ମିଳିମିଳା ହାରପୁଟି ଏସବୁ ଡାକ୍ତରମାନେ ତା ମୂଳ ବୀଜ ବୁଡ଼େଇ ଦେଲେ ଆଉ ସିଏ ଏଇନେ ଦେଖା ନାହିଁ
Residing in Kandira village of districts Bartanda area, Nanda Prusti provides pre-primary and primary education to his students and then advises them to join a proper school. He also teaches adults about basic alphabets and numbers in the evening. It was in his 20s when Nanda was working in an agricultural firm that he realized his colleagues were unaware of basic Hindi and Odia alphabets. He then decided to teach them so that they can do their signatures at the list. Later, at the age of 30, he started his school under a tree beside his home and started giving free of cost education to young children. The government tried to offer Nanda with a permanent building to run his school. However, even at such a senior age, Nanda refuses to take it and continues to teach his children under the tree. His endeavors are highly applauded by locals and his fellow villagers.
आज लगभग 75 साल से वो लोगों को यहां बैठा कर चाटसाली जिसको बोलते हैं वहां लोगों को शिक्षा दान करते हैं और उनका इतना इसमें हबी हो गया है कि वो एक भी पैसा किससे भी नहीं लेते आज तक वो 70-75 साल हो गया है लोगों को पढ़ाई मतलब पढ़ाई में ध्यान देते हैं लोगों कैसे पढ़ाई करोगे क्या करोगे ये सब लोगों को समझाते हैं यहाँ छोटे बच्चे आते हैं यहाँ कम से कम 30-40 बच्चे सुबह वो लेकर बैठ जाते हैं पढ़ाने के लिए वो आज तक इनका काम चल रहा है अभी तक वो बंद नहीं हुआ है उनको 104 साल हो गया है आज तक वो आँखों में चश्मा भी नहीं दिए है फिर भी वो पढ़ाई जा रहे हैं
Continuing his practice for the last 75 years, Nanda is now teaching the fourth generation of his first batch students, and it is due to his efforts that many of his fellow villagers and their children are now able to read and write numbers and their native language, Oriya.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindya@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.